going to discuss about how nerve tissue cause an action as well as mechanism of feedback. So we will discuss first the nerve tissue cause an action. So how these nerve tissues cause action? Nerve tissues cause an action. Nerve tissue cause an action means the topic is how nerve tissue cause an action. How contraction and relaxation, as soon as motor impulses or motor nerve bring impulses to the effector region, immediately effector organ, effector muscles cause an action by showing contraction or relaxation in the muscles. So how these things are possible? These things are possible because of change, structural and functional change in types of protein which are responsible for contraction and relaxation of muscles. And those proteins present in muscles are basically protein actin and myosin. Because of this actin and myosin only muscles shows contraction and relaxation. How this actually muscles means muscles are made up of muscle fibers. Muscles are made up of muscles fibers. And these muscle fibers are again made up of myofibrils. Muscles are made up of muscle fibers. And these muscle fibers are made up of myofibrils. And these myofibrils, this long structure or thread-like structure is made up of protein. That is the arrangement, sequential arrangement of protein. So here which proteins are there? Suppose from here to here, actin. Then here to here, myosin. Again, actin. Again, myosin. Likewise, alternate arrangement of actin and myosin. Continuously one acting, protein actin, then myosin come and bind with, again actin come and bind, again myosin come and bind. In this way long filament form. Such 10 filaments together form a muscle fiber. And these muscles fiber together form muscles. So whenever muscles shows contraction or relaxation, by the time arrangement of actin and myosin get changed. How this arrangement get changed? Actually, there are bands. Suppose from here to here, this is the band. Appears like a band. This is band of actin, protein actin. Then another band is of protein myosin. Suppose from here to here, this is the band of myosin. Again, it is followed by band of actin. And in continuous manner. Actually, this whole mechanism is little bit descriptive one, where calcium channels are there. They are working as soon as the stimuli receive. Calcium channels are there. They change the shape and attract, and all this descriptive part is there. Just we know how these muscles shows contraction and relaxation. For that, introductory part is introduced here. So these actin and myosin, these are the types of protein which form muscle fibers. And now as soon as external stimuli received by nerve muscles, now these proteins will change their shape and arrangement. How change their shape and arrangement? Change their shape and arrangement means, now suppose this actin band, both actin band come closer. Actually, they are not stick with each other. They are hold together by force. So here, this both actin comes together. And myosin band moves slight up. It moves slight up in this way. It moves slight up. As soon as stimuli receive, for suppose stimuli receive, impulses receive to contract hand. Then what is the length? Normal length of fiber is this much. Now after receiving the impulse, length is this much. means from this side this much is getting short, from this side this part is getting contract, and length of muscle get shortened. If relaxation or stress is there, then again they change their shape, then myosin remain here and actin moves away from each other. Actin moves away from each other and there is a band of elasticity in between. This band is there. So now here what happened? Here the length get increased. Go away from each other, and here is elasticity is there as it is attached with some special type of band or chemical, and it get increased. The length get increased. Now here length is increased. This much length increase from both the side. That is the extension or stretch. If impulse comes like that, as soon as impulses moves away, because nervous impulses are electric in nature, so they come at faster rate. Whatever speed they are coming with, whatever speed, with same speed they goes back. So as soon as impulses goes back or move away, then these band come in the natural condition. It retain its natural shape. So this is the way how this, as soon as impulses receive, how nerve tissue shows cause of action, or how they get contract and they get relaxed. That is only they are showing the action by contraction and relaxation of muscles. So as soon as impulses come, this actin and myosin, these are the special type of proteins, and these proteins make muscles. And because of change in the structure, or you can change in the location of the protein, muscles shows contraction and relaxation till impulses are there. As soon as impulses goes, again they come to their natural position or natural stage. There one thing we left to discuss, difference between nervous system and endocrine system. What is the difference between nervous system and endocrine system? In nervous system, impulses move in a form of electric impulses. That is the very faster rate, electric impulses. In case of endocrine system, impulses run or move in form of chemicals. Here in nervous system, movement or speed of impulse is very very fast, whereas in case of endocrine system, speed of impulse is very very slow. Nervous system composed of neuron, endocrine system composed of glands. These are some of the important difference. The effect of nervous system or impulses, effect of impulse comes with nervous system or through nerve channel. That effect remain for very short period of time, whereas effect of the impulses which comes with endocrine system or in form of chemicals, that effect remain for a long period of time. That is the difference between endocrine system and nervous system. Both are useful to carry impulses or pass message from region of origination or originating to the target region, but there are certain differences. Now the one topic related with hormonal system, that is the feedback mechanism. What is feedback mechanism? In feedback mechanism, what is feedback mechanism? Feedback mechanism means when body gives feedback for secretion of hormones. Under this mechanism, feedback mechanism controls the amount of secretion of hormone in particular time duration. In what much time, how much amount of our hormone has to be secreted is decided by feedback mechanism. For example, if we talk about insulin, what is the role of insulin? Insulin helps to control blood sugar level. It helps to control blood sugar. Now, as we consume food, carbohydrates, this carbohydrate turns into glucose. So, carbohydrates turns to glucose. As soon as carbohydrate turns into glucose, immediately insulin is secreted, and this insulin makes other cells to absorb or consume this glucose. Insulin make cells to consume this glucose, and in this way glucose which mix with blood is absorbed or consumed by cells, and then cells perform the process of respiration. So for consumption of glucose by cell, insulin is secreted immediately as soon as glucose enters in blood. But what amount of insulin has to be secreted? Proper amount of insulin has to be secreted so that sufficient amount of glucose is absorbed by different cells. But if amount of insulin is less, for time being, if less insulin is secreted, amount of insulin is less, then what will happen? Sufficient amount of glucose will not be secreted by cells. Sufficient amount of glucose will not be absorbed by the cells. And as a result, glucose level will increase. Glucose level will increase in blood. Because of lack of insulin, level of glucose will increase in blood. So, level of glucose will increase in the blood because of less secretion of insulin. So, sufficient amount of insulin has to be secreted. If insulin is secreted, if we say that level of insulin or insulin maintain the level of glucose, so if insulin is secreted more, if more insulin is secreted for time being, then what will happen? More and more consumption of glucose will take place. As more and more means complete glucose, there is a less amount of glucose will remain there. Now no amount of glucose will left over in the blood. Requirement of body will increase more and more, and might be person leads to one or other disease like coma. Person may go to coma because of less amount of glucose. Much more amount of insulin is secreted, which is extremely harmful for our body, which is not good for our body. So to maintain this level of insulin in body, the mechanism of feedback is there, so that proper optimum amount of hormone has to be secreted to fulfill the requirement of body, as well as to give result to different metabolic processes as well as biochemical processes. If amount of hormone is more, then also it leads to certain diseases. So there is particular requirement of body is like that, specific amount of hormone in specific period of time, not less nor more. Now in control of feedback mechanism, when control this material or this hormonal system, two type of feedback, one is positive feedback and another is negative feedback. Positive feedback is carried out very rarely, whereas negative feedback is carried out generally. Positive feedback means to make glands to secrete more amount of hormone, and negative feedback means to control secretion of hormone or make it to control less or stop the secretion. So generally we perform negative feedback mechanism, very rarely the requirement for positive feedback. So that is about the feedback mechanism, which is very very essential for proper mechanism and proper metabolic process of the body. So here we complete the topic related with hormonal system as well as nervous system in animal. Now we have to study how control and coordination takes place in plants.